Yeah man, say it again. Yeah man, still with some good news for all my viewers and subscribers. One of the world's largest airlines based in Dubai, known as Emirates Airline, has taken interest in our island home, Jamaica, as a destination to which they can provide service. The Emirates name is very popular in the football arena as one of the sponsors for some of your major football clubs. Yes, Jamaica has been seen as far away as Dubai as a destination which is attractive for passengers to come and have a great time. But before I tell you how they'll get from Dubai to our island paradise to have their taste of the Jamaican jerk chicken, let me just explain a little to you what Emirates Airline is. This explanation will help you to understand how big of an achievement this is for Jamaica, our island home. Emirates Airlines is the flagship of the United Arab Emirates, based in Dubai. The largest passenger aircraft being flown now is the Airbus A380, which has a maximum certified capacity for 853 passengers. By any standards, the Super Jumbo is a massive plane. Based upon what we have read about Dubai, we know that they usually never spare any expense in providing luxury, and their flagship airliner is no different. So they have reduced the capacity of seating from the Emirates Airlines from over 800 to just over 500. And what that does, it provides more leg room for each passenger. So it's a more luxurious environment, a more relaxing, a less crowded cockpit. But with over 500 passengers and one aircraft, that's a large aircraft. Emirates Airlines owns 123 of these super jumbo airplanes. That is by far the largest number of A380 aircraft owned by any airliner. The aircraft in second place would be Singapore Airline, and they have only 17. So you can see the major difference there. So hence, we see how big of an airline this is and what an achievement this is for Jamaica, for such a large airliner all the way in the Middle East to be interested in selling tickets for destination Jamaica. Upon hearing this news that Montego Bay and Kingston has been added to Emirates booking system, so one could go to Emirates website and book a flight from Dubai to Montego Bay, I said to myself immediately that I have to check this out. So I went on their website to do my own investigations. So I went on their website and went ahead to start the process of making a booking for a flight from Dubai to Montego Bay. So as soon as I put on the two section of the, when you're booking the tickets, I put MBJ in there. There it popped up, MBJ Montego Bay. So that means Montego Bay was truly in the system. So I realized that it's there. So I go ahead and proceeded to make my bookings. So I looked at it and I realized that there are several options depending on the day you decide to travel from Dubai to Jamaica. So I'll just give you some of the options as I saw them. Now the quickest option is directly from Dubai to JFK and then from JFK to Montego Bay or Kingston. Other options would take you from Dubai into Europe, into countries like Italy and so forth, and then from Europe to JFK. So that would be a little longer air time. But that's another option also, which is available, as I said, depending on the day which you choose to travel. At this point, I was overwhelmed with happiness when I'm checking this out, because this is saying to me, this is a reality. There is a flight available from Dubai to Jamaica. So I looked at the flight details, and then when I found out now that the answer to the question that I know a lot of persons will be asking, will we be seeing an Emirates plane landing in Kingston or Montego Bay? And the short answer is no, because what actually happens is that JetBlue is responsible for the New York to Jamaica and Montego Bay leg. So you will still notice that you have a booking which says an Emirates flight number, but it would say operated by JetBlue Airways. So that means, it simply means that Emirates is only coming to JFK, and then JetBlue does the leg from New York to the other destinations, which is Montego Bay and Kingston. So this is still good news, very good news indeed. Because what this means, it means a process has started. So if the day comes when the numbers are great enough, you might just have a flight directly from Dubai into Montego Bay. Remember earlier this year, we had a Nigerian airline which did the first direct flight from Nigeria. I think that was Airpeace Airline here earlier this year. So the rock is being seen from far and wide, and Jamaica is an attractive destination for a lot of people all over the world. So much so that the largest, or one of the largest airlines in the world, has taken interest in Jamaica and has officially added Jamaica as a destination to which it sells tickets and provides flight fare. So thanks again everyone for listening to me and for the support you have been giving me in growing this channel. I am very excited about this new prospect for Jamaica, and I know any well-intending Jamaica is very excited about this, because this can only mean goodness for our country, which we so much love and appreciate and want the world to come and see. So thanks again for the support. Please like and subscribe the video. Stewie saying until next time, do enjoy the videos I have out there. Thank you.
853 people in one plane? 853 people in a one plane?
Daddy lie, daddy lie, daddy lie.